cannot see me. All he can see is a bookshelf. But I'm going to. So during the course of the night, I'm going to be reading various things, including a few things that nobody's ever heard before that seemed like they tied into our theme of heartbreak. But I thought I'd start off rather confusingly with something that has absolutely nothing to do with tonight's theme. And I'm doing it for a reason that is kind of a downer and kind of not. I don't know how many of you heard about what happened today in Denmark, where there was a debate on freedom of speech between a bunch of people, including some cartoonists, about what could be said and what couldn't be said, about who you can draw pictures of without getting killed, and who you can't. And the debate, which was just in a cafe in Denmark, had begun, and some people drove past and fired about 200 bullets into the side of the cafe, killing three people. And I thought, you know, I want to read them something I wrote. And this is the thing I wrote a few weeks ago after the Charlie Hebdo massacre. And it's a credo. That's what I believe. I believe that it is difficult to kill an idea because ideas are invisible and contagious and they move fast. I believe that you can set your own ideas against ideas you dislike, that you should be free to argue, explain, clarify, debate, offend, insult, rage, mock, sing, dramatize, and deny. I do not believe that burning, murdering, exploding people, smashing their heads with rocks to let the bad ideas out, drowning them, or even defeating them, will work to contain ideas you do not like. Ideas spring up where you do not expect them, like weeds, and are as difficult to control. I believe that repressing ideas spreads ideas. I believe that people and books and newspapers are containers for ideas, but that burning the people will be as unsuccessful as firebombing the newspaper archives. It is already too late. It is always too late. The ideas are out, hiding behind people's eyes, waiting in their thoughts. They can be whispered, they can be written on walls in the dead of night, they can be drawn. I believe that ideas do not have to be correct to exist. I believe you have every right to be perfectly certain that images of God or prophet or man are sacred and undefilable, just as I have the right to be certain of the sacredness of speech, of the sanctity, of the right to mock, comment, to argue, and to utter. I believe I have the right to think and say the wrong things. I believe your remedy for that should be to argue with me or to ignore me, and that I should have the same remedy for the wrong things that you think. I believe that you have the absolute right to think things that I find offensive, stupid, preposterous, or dangerous, and that you have the right to speak, write, or distribute these things, and that I do not have the right to kill you, maim you, hurt you, or take away your liberty or property because I find your ideas threatening, or insulting, or downright disgusting. You probably think some of my ideas are pretty vile too. I believe that in the battle between guns and ideas, ideas will eventually win because the ideas are invisible and they linger. And sometimes they're even true. E pur si muove. And yet it still moves.